Hi everyone, today I'm doing a review of the Phil Smith Be Gorgeous Dry Clean Revitalizing Dry Shampoo. So I'm going to be comparing it to Batiste, which is what I've always used, and just kind of go through what I think of the product. So I hope you enjoy watching this video. So on with the actual review. Now this came in one of the beauty boxes. Honestly, I can never keep track of which brand box it was that it came in. I just will never remember that now. But obviously this was a full size product that was given probably in the last couple of months. Now I tried this out. I think I probably used it for a month. It's now completely empty. I probably got between maybe 5 and 8 uses out of it. So compared to Batiste, which I'll get onto in a second, this is actually quite a small can, especially for a full size product. But as I said, probably between 5 and 8 uses that I got out of it. With regards to the scent, I think that the scent of it is kind of almost a mix, somewhere in the middle between a perfume and an aftershave. So it is kind of a unisex sort of scent. Now, this was fine by me. I'm quite happy with that because, to be quite honest with you, anything other than the smell of kind of day-old hair is a really welcome thing for me. So I'm more than happy with the scent. With regards to the actual, kind of because it's the original one, you know when you get that sort of white powdery look in your hair and you have to shake it out? Those of us with dark hair will have that all the time. Now, I must say, compared to the normal Batistes, this one definitely didn't give as much of a white cast over your hair that you had to shake out. So that is definitely a plus side to the product. You can also get this in a coloured version, which I think is the same price, but you can get this in the coloured version if you really do want to do so. Now, I would say, comparing it again to Batiste, that the volume that it gives your hair isn't quite as good. So it did do the job, but I don't think that it gave quite the volume that the Batiste gives. So that was something that, you know, I'm kind of on the fence with. If it was a very cheap product, then, you know, cheaper than Batiste, I'd probably buy it, but I'll get onto that in a second. I'm now going to compare that one to the Batiste that I've been using. Now, I normally use the small version. I know they do kind of like a baby version, but I normally use the small version. But at the moment, I've got the sort of medium-sized can. Though this is the cherry one. In all honesty, I don't think it smells that much of cherry, but I like the idea and the packaging was cute, so that be that. But if I compare them in size, obviously you can see this is 200 mils compared to the Phil Smith version of 75 mils. So you've got just short of 3 of these in this Batiste can. So that was the first thing. Now, as I said, if it was cheaper, that'd be great. But I was very surprised to find out that actually these are the same price. In the UK, in Sainsbury's, which is where I saw this one, it was £2.99. And then Boots, Tesco, anywhere like that, sell this can of Batiste for £2.99 as well. So that's the major downfall for me, because really the Batiste has got an alright scent. It does do good volume. Alright, yeah, it's kind of more of a white cast, but obviously again you can get the coloured versions for this, but I don't really mind. But you've got more of a white cast on this, but you've got far more product for your money. So I don't know, it's one of those, whereas in all honesty, there's no way I'd ever buy this at £2.99, because it's almost a little bit bigger than a travel size. I can't believe that this is a full size product. But anyway, if you've tried these, let me know what you think. You know I always love to hear back from you. I hope that you found this review useful, and thanks very much for watching.